Music Biz Weekly this week, it's all about LinkedIn bio. We've got Feature FM joining us this week, and we talk about all the amazing features beyond just linking to the music services now that Feature FM is going to allow you to do through their new LinkedIn bio service. Check it out.
Welcome to the Music Biz Weekly podcast, founded in 2011 and with over 500 weekly episodes, where Michael Brandvold and Jay Gilbert, two longtime music industry pros, discuss the very latest trends, tools, and tactics that you need to succeed in this new...
Hey everybody, welcome back to another episode of the Music Biz Weekly Podcast. I'm one of your two co-hosts, Michael Brandvold, and as always, I'm joined by Jay Gilbert. How you doing this beautiful Thursday, Jay?
Oh, it is a beautiful Thursday. Good to see you, man.
School starts in 1 week. Yes. I can't
oh
believe,
my gosh.
I can't believe summer is over so quickly.
Yeah.
I mean, yeah. You know, I've got an 8-year-old daughter, and it feels like just 2 weeks ago was the last day of school.
Yeah.
And next week she starts.
Gone by in a blur.
And it's just like, I guess I remember that as a kid. We all remember that. It's like all of a sudden summer's over in a blink of an eye.
Yeah. Yeah. Well, good for her. And look, good for us. It's football season. We've got preseason going. Hope springs eternal. Fall is my favorite time of year. It can't get here too fast.
Yep. Yep. I'm there with you. So before we get into this week's great, great interview, yeah. Quick shout out and thank you to Bruce and everybody at Hypebot and Bands in Town for all your support. And of course, a quick reminder, please join our discussion over at the Bands in Town artist community. You can find it at bandsintown.musicbizweeklypodcast.com.
Easy.
It's free to join. Lots of great discussions. We want to hear from you, especially about this week's episode. So head over there when you're done listening and let us know what you think.
Please.
But let's share a little love with our sponsors.
Please.
Bandzoogle.com, built by musicians for musicians. Bandzoogle is an all-in-one platform that makes it easy to build a beautiful website and EPK for your music. Bandzoogle powers the websites for tens of thousands of musicians around the world, from weekend warriors to Grammy winners. All the features you need for a professional website are already built in. Hosting and a custom domain name, dozens of fully customizable design templates. Tools to sell your music and merch commission-free crowdfunding and fan subscription features. I love that Bandzoogle is like commission-free on all of this.
It's awesome.
There's no nickel and diming here. mailing list tools to grow your fan list and send newsletters, social media integrations, and of course, amazing live tech support from their musician-friendly team 7 days a week. We sat down with Bandzoogle, put together a great offer for all of our listeners. Head over to bandzoogle.com, sign up. You can try it for free for 30 days. But when you register, use the promo code, and this is all one word now, the promo code MUSICBIZWEEKLY, and you will save 15% off the first year of any subscription.
Worth every penny.
And of course, discmakers.com. We know it's a digital world, but there's still such an important role for physical media for today's musicians. Digital royalty payments can be so small at selling products like CDs, vinyl, even t-shirts online and at gigs has become such an important income generator. For every CD you sell at a gig, you might need roughly 3,000 streams to make the same amount of money. That's a lot of streams. Our friends at Disc Makers are the place to go for your discs and other physical media, including vinyl, USB drives, and even t-shirts. Yes, Disc Makers can sell you t-shirts.
Yes, sir.
So we put together another great offer that's going to save you some money just for our Music Biz Weekly listeners here. Head over to discmakers.com, place an order for 100 or more CDs. And when you check out in the promo code, again, this is all one word, use the promo code FREEBIZ, and you will save up to $150 in shipping costs. Jay, who's joining us this week?
Today, we are joined by Daniel Sander. He's the Chief Creative Officer at Feature FM. And you want to stay through the end because this is a very good discussion on this whole link in bio economy.
Yeah, he gives Daniel gives us a great update on what's new over at Feature FM, what's coming down the road. But as you said, more importantly, what this whole new link in bio world is all about and why it's so important that you are utilizing this new amazing tool. So let it roll and we'll see you at the end.
Thousands of musicians and industry professionals listen to the Music Biz Weekly podcast. If you have a product or service and would like to reach this audience, get in touch with Michael or Jay to discuss sponsorship
opportunities. Today, we're joined by Daniel Sander, Chief Creative Officer of Feature FM. Daniel, thanks for joining us today.
Thank you for having me. I'm happy to be back.
I was going to say, this is your second or third time, I think, on the podcast.
This is my third time. So,
wow.
Yeah, you know, we got to get green jackets out for these returns.
That's right. Yeah. Join the club. That's exactly. Awesome. Well, welcome back, Daniel. And, you know, for those that don't know, we read a lot about this link in bio economy in music, and it's really grown and it's really important to artists to, you know, well, websites are so different than they used to be. You used to want to send people to your website. Now you want your website to send them somewhere else, right? Or at least, you know, your Feature FM link. Talk a little bit about the link in bio economy.
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, the term link in bio, you know, I think, you know, became very popular as in social media platforms. You know, typically you can only put one link in bio in your profile. So the question is, how do you make it count? But I think for what we've seen with what we would call the link in bio economy, you know, is really part of, you know, more of an underlying need for how marketing strategies have transitioned when, you know, everybody is scrolling through their social media platforms and have short attention spans. And, you know, really you need to send fans in the quickest way to whatever it is you are looking to promote. So it's really kind of coming from this need to transition away from that sort of traditional website that houses everything that you send fans to, and then they kind of scroll through all different parts of your website, more to these just dynamic, easy to create, easy to change landing pages, these kind of mini micro websites, if you will, mm-hmm. where, you know, if you're an artist or if you're a marketer, the need now is, okay, I need to promote a tour. I need to promote a release where artists have, you know, releases every week now, it seems like, you know, they're releasing many singles, or I need to run a contest, or, you know, whatever it is you need to promote around your business as an artist. This whole idea of the link in bio economy is it just created a much easier way for artists to kind of just create these dynamic marketing campaigns so that you can capture those bite-sized attention spans that fans have to just get them to what you want them to do in the quickest way and have them engage and still, you know, still achieve your goal, you know, whether it's capturing an email or selling a piece of merch or a concert ticket or getting someone to stream your music. So, you know, that's what we've seen in terms of what marketers and what artists are now doing when we talk about the link in bio economy. It's much greater than just that single link.
Yeah, you know, I think you really described it well when you said they're micro websites. And, you know, I remember almost 20 years ago, that was a fad. There was a period of time where it was like, okay, you had your website, but then you might build a micro website just for your tour and a micro website just for your album. And the fact that these link in bio pages, and it was one of these things where when they first started popping up, because I'm assuming they were born out of Instagram, because Instagram was the beast that never let you put a clickable URL into mm-hmm. a post. And it was sort of like, how do you get around this? And you can only put one URL, like you said, up in your bio. And initially I was like, I don't quite get this. This is so stupid simple. Why not just put your website URL in mm-hmm. your bio? But what you also hit upon is key to these things. They're so easy to update. And I think as the three of us and so many people know, building a website, even today with all the services that are out there, isn't necessarily the easiest thing to do to actually build. You can go to Wix, of course, but that's still a bit challenging, and updating it a little. There can be some work in updating it. And these LinkedIn bio services are so simple that, I mean, I think that was the beauty of it, that sometimes you see a new product and you go, this is so stupid simple. I don't get the need for this. Well, that's the need right there. It is absolutely simple. And the fact that you're giving musicians this opportunity to create, we can call them micro websites, but you could point your own domain right to your LinkedIn bio. And that is your website. Let's be honest. A website is a destination that you kind of gather all of your assets at. And to Jay's point, you kind of then disseminate and send people back out to where you want them to go. Prior to social media, you wanted everybody to do everything in your website because there was nowhere else to go. Now it's like, why rebuild YouTube? Why rebuild Facebook? You know, why build your own message board commenting system when Facebook groups have that nailed? Direct people from your website there. So to have these LinkedIn bio services become available, I'm a big fan of them now. I really am. I mean, I've actually gotten to the point where I'm like, do I need my full blown website anymore? Can I just use a LinkedIn bio, which is quick to update? And the features that are getting added to LinkedIn bio services are pretty phenomenal when you look at what you can do in these little micro websites.
Yeah, no, I mean, you touched on so many things that I can comment on that in my head, it's even hard to keep track because I think, you know, you really brought to light a lot of important things. I mean, I think that the fragmentation on both the supply side and the demand side, meaning, you know, the fragmentation of where your fans are on so many different platforms. They're on tons of different social media platforms. You know, as you mentioned, you're not going to rebuild YouTube. You're not going to rebuild Instagram. You know, this is where your fans are. At the same time, there's the fragmentation of where all of the artists' content and where all of the artists, you know, where all of the artists' music lives, where all of their content lives. So, you know, you're not necessarily wanting to send fans always to your website. You know, your website should certainly be on your LinkedIn bio page. But, you know, you might want to send a fan to your latest YouTube video. You know, maybe you had a Billboard actually cover your latest release. You're going to instantly put a link to that in your LinkedIn bio. So, you know, your content as an artist in so many different places, so many different streaming services. Maybe there's press coverage. Maybe there's touring. Maybe there's something on YouTube. So, you know, this gives you the ability to easily connect fans to all of that. When it comes to music, I mean, so, you know, there's no shortage of the general concept of, you know, LinkedIn bio. You know, we see them popping up every day. But what we believe at Feature FM is that when it comes to music and it comes to artists, they will always need specialized marketing tools for music.
Yeah.
And this is what we focus on. You know, we double down on focusing on providing tools specifically built for music, specifically built for artists, where we, you know, have tools where we talk about things like pre-saves, and we know the value of a premium stream versus a free stream. And we focus on data and analytics that talks about music. So, you know, this is where we see, you know, if you're an artist and, you know, you're looking for the best way to promote yourself in the music industry, it's important to have tools that are built for you and not kind of trying to fit into sort of a general, you know, a general purpose LinkedIn bio site, because there's the LinkedIn bio, which is sort of the launch pad, right? That's where fans go to get to all of your other stuff. Right. But there's a need for so many different types of, you know, quote unquote, other types of LinkedIn bios, but it's really just other types of landing pages. If you're coming out with a release, you're going to have a pre-save. If you're promoting a release, it's going to be your traditional multi-store smart link. But if you want to run a contest where, you know, fans can follow you on the different streaming platforms to enter contest entries. If you want to promote, you know, maybe you're running a podcast as an artist, you can promote your podcast. If you're on tour, you want to pull in all of your tour dates. So as an artist, whatever it is you need to promote around your business, you know, there's a need for something kind of greater than just what's in that original link in bio, but for sending fans to those other marketing campaigns that are built around your business.
Yeah, you're right. I mean, music is so different than other businesses. And I love that this product is built around music for all of those things that you just mentioned. And maybe a few, like, I would love to know if there's anybody doing something creative. I mean, do you ever get surprised? You have some really great partners. I was reading about Ditto and Secretly Group and Empire and AWOL. And is anybody doing something, you know, that surprises you sometimes? I know that today, sometimes people are getting into digital collectibles, things like NFTs and things like that. There's, you know, the obvious things like merch and pre-save and some of those things. But how are your clients using this product? Are there any surprises?
Yeah, I don't know if the word is surprises, but more like best practices, like things that we see customers doing that, you know, are sort of playbooks that I think artists can emulate. And, you know, we're working to kind of build out more education around what those playbooks could look like. Yeah, when it comes to the NFTs and digital collectibles, that's, you know, it's a great point. You know, what, like I said, whatever it is around the artist business that they want to promote to help, you know, make them money, to help them build their career. You know, the traditional ones, recorded merch, live music, but, you know, now we see NFTs. So we built, you know, we integrated all of the NFT stores into Feature FM. So you can easily add them on your landing pages. You know, in terms of some of the best practices, you know, one of them, which is probably one of our most popular features, is something called the Spotify multiple follow. And what it means is that when you are asking fans to pre-save on Spotify, for example, you can add up to three other Spotify assets that you want followed. Typically, it's going to be your artist profile, right, a playlist, it can be a user profile. And this way, when fans are pre-saving in the one click, you know, they're also going to be following those assets. And that follow happens today. So it's
right. And that's huge, right? Yeah. Because if you get followed on Spotify, now when you release music, it drops into Release Radar, Discover Weekly, you know, radio, those types of things. Yeah. Is there an opportunity on YouTube for them to subscribe to your YouTube channel?
Yes, there is. So yeah, we have a YouTube subscribe ability as well. I think that making the most use out of these authentication types of actions is definitely a best practice. And, you know, there's the sort of underlying reason behind that is that, you know, another core value that we really focus on is if you want to build a career as an artist in the music industry, you know, not just have a song go viral, but actually build a sustainable career, the most important thing you can do is build relationships with your fans. You have to have direct access to your fans and know who they are. So, you know, all of these types of actions are ways in which fans can opt into sharing their email address with you. In addition to just self-subscribing, they can enter their email address. But because of this core value, you know, we want to make it as easy as possible for fans to kind of build those relationships and be able to communicate with your fans. So if we're talking about kind of another best practice, as you're collecting those fan emails, you know, you need to make sure that if they pre-saved your music, on release day, they're getting an email from you that says, hey, the music you pre-saved is out. Here's a link to go listen to it. You know, you need to focus on conversion. What's going to get fans to stream your music the most? And you need to remind them, hey, you know, you were interested in this. Now it's time to go and take that action that you wanted. We just added actually automatic fan notifications. So that's now actually happening automatically. But you know, in general, you know, you can sync your email addresses to your MailChimp account directly from Feature FM to your ActiveCampaign account. So these are some of the integrations that, you know, some of our advanced users are using, but that any artist has access to that they should be doing, because this is what's really going to generate those additional conversions for you. Yeah.
This link in bio evolution that you're talking about here seems so natural for Feature FM, because companies like Feature FM were actually kind of doing these link in bio services before it was ever a concept. You know, the music landing pages that we initially started with, go here and it's just got links to all of your services. That in itself was a link in bio. It just didn't have all the bells and whistles we're used to now. But for you guys to now say, okay, and as a user of those types of services, it was always one of those things, geez, why can't I put my tour dates on my music landing page?
Yeah.
Why can't I put my YouTube video that I'm premiering on there? Why can't I do an email gathering? If I'm sending them there for music, why? So it seemed like such a logical and natural evolution for you guys to go, okay, you know, we've mastered the music landing page. Now we're just adding more things, more bells and whistles, basically, to your page. We're giving you the option to add all of this stuff. What can you kind of give us a high level overview of the various music services, not DSPs, but other things like for tour dates, and you know, where can you embed videos from, and do you support e-commerce stores and all? Can you run through a feature list of who you and services you integrate with?
Yeah, exactly. And yeah, that background was definitely on point, right? It kind of started with, you know, the recorded side. I have a release and, you know, I need an easy way to send fans to, you know, all of my releases. And, you know, everything that we build essentially comes out of the need of our customers, you know, what they're doing, what's going to help drive their business forward. And, you know, our customers are artists. So, you know, over time, as we've built those relationships with artists and really understood more about what they need, yeah, we've added those exact functionalities. So we partnered with Bands in Town about a year ago to launch our Tour Links product. So all of your tour dates are automatically pulled in to create a landing page of all of your tour dates. And you can constantly sync it to from Bands in Town so that they're constantly updated. Past tour dates will, you know, will disappear. If it's sold out, it will say sold out. You can embed media, so on any of your landing pages, fans can actually just consume the content right there without going somewhere else. So you can embed YouTube videos, Spotify players, SoundCloud players, so that way right on your you know, essentially your link in bio page, fans can just consume the content right there.
And I think to that point, it's important to remind musicians that you still get the view counts, the play counts. So if you embed that YouTube video, you embed Spotify, and somebody listens to it in the landing page, you're still going to get the count on YouTube or Spotify. You're not losing anything by doing that.
That's important.
Right. And it's, yeah, the way that it's built. So like with YouTube, for example, as long as somebody actually clicks like the YouTube button to play, you get the count. I know that if it's, you know, if somebody integrates and it's on like autoplay, I actually don't think that counts. But as long as the video is there and somebody clicks the play button, yeah, you get that view. When you embed from Spotify, it's like, you know, think of it as like, you know, the Spotify website is just kind of shrunk and put into your landing page. So somebody's actually hitting play and it's playing from Spotify. So yeah, you're exactly right on those points. So it's just a faster way for fans to consume it. And then they can always click to go to Spotify to learn more. I think one of the, you know, one of the other integrations that I think sets it apart is, you know, kind of going back to what makes it music focused and what gives you the ability to collect fan contact info, which is, you know, those action buttons. So, you know, when we have a button that says follow on Spotify, it's not just going to Spotify, the fans actually logging in with their Spotify account. We're making sure they follow you. And the fan can opt in to share their email address with you.
Right within the landing page.
Right within the landing page, exactly. So when that's happening, you know, you're getting all of those benefits, and that's supported for, you know, for Spotify, for YouTube, for Deezer, and, you know, a number of other services. Apple Music, you can also authenticate. Apple, as a company, doesn't support the ability to share the email address, but we built a way so that fans can still say, hey, as part of the, you know, as part of the authentication, I still want to share my email address, and they can type it.
Yeah.
What email services do you support?
For sending emails?
Well, for gathering emails and having a fan added to an email list.
Yeah. So there's dozens of ways for fans to actually share their email address. So, you know, any of these authentication options are one of them. We also have just an email collection form. So on any landing page, you can just have an open field that says subscribe to my email list, and fans type in their email address. All of those fans and emails are stored in an audience CRM dashboard inside of your Feature FM account. Those can either be exported, or you can sync them in real time to MailChimp to active campaign. We're adding more integrations. So, you know, you can essentially, you know, we call it, you can put your email subscriber growth on autopilot, you know, as long as you should always have that email collection form in your LinkedIn bio, or any of your landing pages, but there's the actual product called the LinkedIn bio, which you can, you know, essentially put on autopilot and constantly sync with your MailChimp account and, you know, have rules that they're automatically getting emails. Yeah.
It works really well. I would recommend, though, that people make sure that they check, because I had done some campaigns through Feature FM and I hadn't been in a few weeks, and I went in there and, you know, by campaign, I can see all the emails that I've captured, and there were a lot.
Yeah.
And it's super important, because as you mentioned earlier, now you own that fan. You've got a relationship with that fan and you can communicate with that fan. I honestly was surprised at the amount of emails that we were able to capture that people were. But if you think about it, if it's one of your favorite artists, you have no problem saying, yeah, keep me up to date. Here's my email.
Yeah, no, you're exactly right. And I think that, you know, that happened, this all happened when kind of the, you know, official kind of LinkedIn bio flexible type of landing page kind of came up. And I want to go back to something that you said before, which is, you know, before there was this kind of like LinkedIn bio type of concept, you know, we had the music focused landing pages, and, you know, artists would use these URLs as their LinkedIn bio, which they still do today. And for many kinds, it does make sense. You have a release, you just want that to be the one thing that's in your LinkedIn bio. But as we expanded to go into, you know, tour marketing and go into running contests and promoting your podcast, or, you know, any of these other types of landing pages, it made sense to still have, you know, just a consistent landing page that you can constantly update to connect all of these other things. And that became like the official, you know, LinkedIn bio product. So every artist that signs up to Feature FM automatically gets a LinkedIn bio created for them on sign up. They give us their Spotify URL. We find them in all of the other services, their artist profile pages, their social media platforms, and automatically, without doing anything, they have a LinkedIn bio with links to all of their main profiles that they can start using. And now they can, you know, as they continue to use the product and promote to other areas, all of those other types of links can be automatically pulled into your LinkedIn bio. So that can be kind of your, you know, your static landing page that just sits in your LinkedIn bio, and you're constantly updating it with, you know, whatever it is you need to promote around your business.
We're starting to see more and more people integrate with Shopify stores. Are you looking at that?
Yeah, certainly. I think that, you know, Shopify has become the most popular platform to run your merch store, to run your e-com store. What we're doing today with Shopify is we have an ability to actually track your sales. So if you're sending fans to your Shopify store to buy merch to your e-com store, you can actually track sales that came from any of your Feature FM landing pages after a fan goes to that Shopify store. So that's where we are now. We certainly have plans to have more of a deeper integration, essentially opening access to buy merch directly on your landing page, you know, without even going to the store. So I think these are all exciting things, right? It's looking at what is the most convenient way for the fan to complete that action, you know, whatever it is you want them to do, without too many steps. And that's what we strive towards.
Go ahead, Mike.
I was going to say, is there anything else on the roadmap that you are free to reveal?
We won't tell anyone.
that's okay. Yeah, I mean, I think that, you know, as a company, what we're focusing on is, you know, again, diving deeper into what will allow artists to build and nurture their fan relationships. So when, you know, we're talking about where we are today with collecting fan emails, syncing it to email platforms, kind of managing your audience, you know, these are all areas that we're certainly looking to expand upon. So without kind of specific features and specific ways to do that, this is certainly an area of the company that we see driving a lot of value for our customers, being able to dive deeper into that. Enhancing integrations is also helpful. You know, at the end of the day, every artist or every marketer is using a number of different platforms to do their jobs. And if we can make it easier for those platforms to connect with each other, it makes it easier and more convenient for them. So it goes back to even like the very first thing we started talking about, which is, you know, why these landing pages are so popular is about convenience. You know, they're so easy to set up. You can set them up in, you know, a matter of seconds for the most part. You know, it really made it easy to just generate these landing pages for whatever you need to promote. So anything that drives more towards that convenience aspect as well is another big area that we're focusing on.
Yeah. As we wind down, I want to make sure that we cover kind of my favorite part of Feature FM, and that's really the dashboard and the reporting. Talk a little bit about not only the data that is captured and shared, but how it's presented.
Yeah. So across every, so across every link or landing page that you create in Feature FM, you get analytics and data in real time, both at the link level. So if you create a tour link, you see what are the analytics just for this tour link. If you create a pre-save link, what are the analytics just for this pre-save, your link in bio, et cetera. And then there's an aggregated analytics view. So at the artist level, across all of these different links and landing pages, if you have, you know, 10 release links and one tour link, and you've done two contests, you have an aggregated view of all of these, of all of the links at the artist level. So you can see, how am I doing as an artist? You know, across everything I've promoted, everything I've done as a business, what's integrated in my bio link, where do my fans come from? You know, what social media platforms are they coming, are they finding me from? You know, which streaming services do my fans use the most? Where are my fans located? You know, all of these are kind of simple questions you can answer. You can, you know, dive a little bit deeper when it comes to looking at, you know, did this Facebook post perform better than this tweet that I did, et cetera. But the ability to kind of look at that aggregated view as an artist, you know, really kind of ties it all together. So you're not stuck in just being tunnel visioned into, you know, campaign by campaign.
Yeah.
But when it comes to the data, I mean, you know, so I asked a few questions and said, these are questions you can answer. This is what we always recommend to any artist. You know, a lot of people talk about big data, you know, a lot of people talk about analytics. And I think oftentimes if you're just going into data without knowing what you're looking for, it can be very scary. You can get very lost. But what we try to do and what we recommend to, you know, to artists is, you know, before you even go look at the data, maybe even before you start the campaign, you should write down, what is it that you're trying to answer? You know, what are the questions that you want to know? If you go into it and you go into an analytics dashboard knowing what you're looking for, it's 10 times easier to understand and to actually answer those questions and then get better. Because at the end of the day, analytics, it's all about understanding what works and then,
you know, making it actionable, right? Being able to take that data and actually do something with it. Daniel, where can people learn more about you, learn more about Feature FM, this whole link in bio economy? Where should people go?
I mean, there's a couple of places. We have a great repository of past webinars that we've run. So if you're looking to get educated, you can go to our YouTube channel. We have all of our webinars up on our YouTube channel. They talk about everything from retargeting to social media strategy. Our blog as well is a great resource to just look at what are the different, what are the most recent products and features that we've launched? What do they do? So if you want to keep up to date on just what products and features are available, you can do that there. And then, you know, the best of all is learning by doing. You can go to Feature FM, sign up, create an account, start using the tools, and you know, that'll really help you get the best experience for just diving into what's possible.
Awesome. Thanks so much for taking the time out of your busy day to chat with us. We really appreciate it.
It's always good to catch up on what's going on and what's new with Feature FM.
Yeah.
I really appreciate it.
Keep us up to date, and maybe, you know, we'll talk again on your fourth visit and we'll get all the updates.
I can't wait.
All right.
Thanks, Daniel.
Thanks, Daniel. Appreciate it, man.
Visit discmakers.com to place an order for 100 or more CDs. And when you check out, use promo code FREEBIZ and get free shipping up to a $150 value.
I love getting the update on what Feature FM's doing. And, you know, as I said in the discussion, what a natural and obvious evolution for Feature FM to start adding these other features, because they've been doing these landing pages before landing pages were ever thought of. And, you know, and I remember even when it was just music landing pages, I'm like, how can I tweak this to make it work for not music? I want to add this to it. Can I put a YouTube link in here? And it's like, oh yeah, but I can't embed the video, but I can put a YouTube link in.
Yeah.
You know, so it's just natural. And while they're evolving this way, you're seeing the plethora of link in bio services out there evolving towards music, going, now you can add music links to all of your link in bio pages. It's like, yeah, but I've already got that. I've already been using this service to do this.
Yeah. And I love that we talked about this becoming a website, because websites, you know, 10 years ago, you wanted to have your news on there and your videos on there and all of these things. Today, you want people to get off of your website as soon as possible to either buy a ticket, stream the music. They can get up to minute information on you at a variety of different sources, right? You want to have a contact form there. You want those basics. I love the idea of a Feature FM landing page as acting as a website.
Yeah.
And just getting that call to action.
You can just, you know, all these services allow you to use custom domains. So you can do that. You could just redirect a domain. But there's absolutely no reason that link in bio page could not be your fully functioning website. And it's much faster to update. It's much easier. Yeah. You don't have to hire a developer. You're not pulling your hair out because oh my God, what's going on with my WordPress? There's a plugin that's conflicting you know, and you can add simple links. I mean, again, these link in bios are basically any URL you can put in.
Yeah.
So if you wanted to put you want to put a bunch of press hits, okay, just put the link in and here's the article and you click it and it goes, it sends the people to the destination to read it, which is what you want to do anyway. And, you know, then you can, a year from now, remove them when they're old news, when they're not important. It's very easy to manage these types of these sites to keep them fresh.
Yeah.
And again, look at where these were all born out of. Instagram. You know,
because of the limitation.
You know, there, I can't tell you. I mean, for years, it's like, God, you know, I want to promote the new article or the new YouTube video on Instagram, but I can't. I can put the link there, but it'll just going to show up as a URL and it can't be clicked. It's not a good user experience. Yeah. How do I utilize my Instagram audience to feed traffic into all of these other URL destinations? Yeah. That's what a link in bio was born out of.
Sure.
Because as you you'll see this all the time, people make a post and they click link in bio.
Yeah, exactly.
So you go up to the bio, click the link, here's where to go. We've said this a few times and I'm going to remind people this again. You've got to be aware of where you're posting that though. A lot of people still like to have an Instagram post automatically post to Facebook. But on Instagram, they're writing, click the link in bio to view the video, to read the article, to do something. Works fine on Instagram.
Right.
On Facebook, that doesn't work. It still says click link in bio. There's no bio that has a link in it on Facebook.
Right.
I literally just commented on somebody's post yesterday. I'm like, that said click link in bio. I go,
because the two were linked, the Instagram,
yeah, their
and
Instagram
Facebook
automatically
linked.
Posted to Facebook. It said on Facebook, click the link in bio to visit or watch this. And I just commented, there is no link in your bio. So
it's a good point.
Those little things you do need to be aware of. Don't get super lazy and just put click link in bio everywhere. Because again, some of these services don't have that sort of functionality.
Yeah.
I mean,
yeah.
TikTok, that could work. But, you know, on TikTok, you've got to get 1,000 followers before you can put a link in your bio. But other services like Facebook, at that doesn't make sense. Yeah. Facebook group doesn't make sense. You can put the actual real link right in there and people can click the real link. So,
And the only thing I would add to this is that you can set it up so easily. Like I have MailChimp and I can have my email addresses that is captured, drop those into this email list just automatically there, which is amazing. But before we set that up, I remember going in and looking at some of these campaigns we were running, and I would click on the campaigns to see, you know, how they were doing. And there are all these email addresses. So make sure that you're aware that you're capturing those.
Yeah. If you've
reach
got a
out
form,
to them, hey, thanks for following.
Yeah. If you've
thing.
Got a form capturing some data and it's not automatically being imported somewhere, and it, you know, because a lot of these services will just dump it into a CSV
that's
file,
right.
which you can export and then
that's
import
right.
it somewhere else.
Yep.
Make sure you're going in there and taking that data that you've been gathering.
it might surprise you how many emails you have in there, and that's money in the bank.
And listen, I mean, just like having a website, you do have to keep your LinkedIn bio page updated.
Yeah, you should be refreshing that all the time,
depending on
where
you're
at.
You know, don't have last year's tour being promoted on there. Don't have last year's video when you've got newer videos.
Or members of the band that aren't in the band anymore.
There's no excuse not to update them because they, as we just talked about, they are so simple to update. I mean, literally, the drummer in your band can do it, people.
Ouch. Well, no, you're absolutely right. And what we've talked about before is make sure that periodically you are doing things like updating it. Maybe you set an Outlook reminder, and then, you know, we always talk about change your passwords, update your socials, your banners, and all of those things, update your link, do it on a regular basis, whether it's monthly, quarterly, whatever works for you, but set that reminder in your calendar so you don't miss it.
Yeah. So, kind of a homework for our artist community page over at Bands in Town. Are you using Feature FM? Have you expanded beyond just the music links to use the full link and bio functions? What do you think?
Yeah.
What's your experience been? Are there features you would like to see them add? Services you'd like to see them support? Because as Daniel said, you know, they're doing this for their customers. They follow the customer's lead. So if you're a customer, you know, is there a service that you're like, you know, why don't you support this? Why can't I pull this in? Why? What would it be that would make it much easier for you? So head over to bandsintown.musicbizweeklypodcast.com. Join our artist community discussion over there.
Please.
And let us know what you think.
Yep. We'll see you over there.
All right, everybody. That's it. One more quick shout out to Bruce and everybody at Hypebot and Bands in Town, and of course to our sponsors Bandzoogle and Disc Makers. Thank you so much. We'll see everybody next week.
musicbizweeklypodcast.com. Subscribe on YouTube, follow and rate us on Spotify. Subscribe and leave a review on iTunes. We appreciate your support.
For Music Biz Weekly, provided by larrydavisvoice.com and by jessicamarsvoice.com. That's Mars with a Z.